kinds of clothes, brand new clothes on, designer clothes. Just tweeds, layers of fashion tweeds. Mm. All three of them, with hats. And I was like, I couldn't. It was straight out of a 30s. But they were very serious about it, mm. The chauffeur and Jean. But I think Jean might think that I love Ramel, which is true. But and they are competing, or they're opponents, mm-hmm. and it doesn't stop me from not liking them.
Mm-hmm. How does he like his show, Mary Boone?
I like his paintings. I don't like his shows very much. I really much prefer just certain works or only studio. But this one was coping with the idea of a show to a certain extent. But really, it never makes such a great show for me. Like with David, I thought the show was better than the individual pieces. David and Peter's. Whereas with John, I never think of his work in a gallery. When I think of him and his work, I think of a lot of ideas. Individual pictures, details of pictures, or his studio, mm-hmm. or other people's houses. I never remember the galleries. It's a blank spot for me. It's not where I enjoy the work.
In 1978, that's when he left the same room and went to the primitive painting style. That same year there was a Haitian art exhibit at the Brooklyn Museum. Did you ever talk about that museum?
No.
Do you think he's been influenced at all by Haitian art, or did he pay attention to it?
I don't think anybody thought of it until the art world thought of it. It's funny that I excluded myself from the art world. You know, when the first write-ups about him came up as a Haitian graffiti artist, mm-hmm. which he was neither, in my book, I never in my life thought of a Haitian graffiti artist. Mm-hmm. I thought of this kid, this trendsetter, brilliant prima donna, mm-hmm. Broody, moody, kid whom I know had. I rarely saw him with other blacks, but I knew that he had ties. Like he did work together with like Fab Five and a couple of other people. Then he had a Mohawk, his Mohawk days, at a studio he got from an English pop artist. You know, in that, so he did see black people, but I didn't see him with black people. I mostly saw him with.
He disavows that whole period. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sure that he will mellow about that later. I mean, but we never thought of him as a Haitian. Mm-hmm. And when he hit the art world, what to me was so great is that people didn't know how to deal with it. They still don't cope with the content. I saw his work sold in Europe like hotcake to people who don't speak a word of English. And even if they did, they wouldn't know what kind of English that is. And in Jean's English, what it might mean. So they were losing so much meaning. They still didn't know how to. What I loved about Jean, that he broke in as a star, not only as a painter. Yes, he had to be painterly to be a darling, but he really came in as a star, and people didn't quite know it. He got a few punches because of reactions against, you know, people don't like stars. Mm-hmm. But people who were throwing the punches didn't know why they were punching. Mm-hmm.
Here's the first rock star.
And it was a fantastic thing to come in. Yeah, it was a momentous thing to have a painter who comes in as a star. Yeah. I mean, Julian made himself to be a star from the position of being a painter, and more painting, and then a star. But this kid entered
the
star.
He really never had the rock star thing, though, Dan, so much.
Julian?
Yeah.
Oh, no, he's not at all a rock star. I mean, and Jean has all the aspects of that. But right now, I mean, right now in the last season, the rhetoric, the dialogue about his work is a lot of Haitian and black aesthetic, you know, referencing him into that area, which I think is brilliant strategy. Whether he thought about it or not, I'm sure that he doesn't mind. I know he doesn't mind.
Well, he asked Paris Thompson, who's the expert on Haitian art, to write the catalog.
Yeah, he didn't quite ask, he was recommended.
No.
But it was brilliant because this finally is going to shut up the graffiti talk. Mm-hmm. It took like how many years to shut up the graffiti talk? And nobody really ever even discussed the way he, in fact, would be able to be related to graffiti, rather than just the fact that he's black and he's the same generation, and he really wasn't spray can much at all. But the way he works is that great, great first nature, not even second nature of a graffitiist, of just hitting, and you know, it's automatic, the hands just go, you just hit anything inside. Jean works like that, almost like a toreador with the surfaces around him. And he works on several things at once with two hands and several crayons.
Mm-hmm.
And it's that